Today I am discussed about solar power generation. Solar power is the conversion of energy from sunlight into electricity. We can generate the solar power with the help of the sunlight, that is the solar radiation. We can generate the power that converts the sunlight into direct electricity. But the output in the form of DC, after that we can convert it into AC with the help of inverter, that is DC to AC converter. Solar cell, which converts light energy into electric current using the photovoltaic effect due to the solar radiation, we are generating the power. That is, directly we can convert the solar radiation into electricity, but the output in the form of DC. And here it consists of two methods. One is nothing but the on-grid system, another one is for the off-grid system. On-grid system, another one is for the off-grid system. In renewable energy sources, the initial cost is more. In renewable energy sources, the initial cost is more. It is not continuous and constant power generation and generate the less amount of power. Comparing to the conventional power plant, in renewable energy sources, it is not continuous and constant power generation and generate the less amount of power. In renewable energy sources, that is either solar, wind, tidal, 60% of cost is concerned for the battery because it is far away from the consumers and it is not continuous and constant power generation. We need to store whenever the power generation is available, we need to store that we can utilize the backup purpose whenever the supply is not available with the help of battery. With the help of battery. In market, the battery is available a number of things, that is lead acid battery, lithium ion, lithium cadmium, so on, etc. If the solar power plant are two types, one is nothing but the on-grid system, another one is for the off-grid system. On-grid system means without the battery, they can connect it to the grid, and off-grid system means with battery, we can utilize the electricity. Now we can observe in this the diagram. You can observe in this diagram. Actually, the solar sun sets on the sun rises on the east and sun sets on the west. The solar panel we are placing in the direction of east-west direction. The PV panel we can place in the direction of east-west direction. That is, sun rises in the east and sun sets on the west. Now, in on-grid system, directly connected to the grid mechanism. In off-grid system, we can connect it into the battery. Now, you can observe here, that is daytime from east side, sun started and set on the west. Now, in this the period, 4 to 6 hours or 4 to 8 hours, we are generating the power. Now, clearly you can observe here, once in the top of the roof, they are placed for the PV panel. This is the PV panel. This is like a array, n number of rows and then column. The solar radiation is sent to the, that is the power is, the solar radiation directly converted into the electricity in the form of DC that given into the inverter. That given into the inverter, which converts DC to AC and send it to the electric panel board. If the person is required, they can utilize the electricity or through smart meter connected to the grid. This is the data. In night time, you can observe here, in the night time, just you can observe here. In night time, the power is not generated. The night time, the power is not generated. Just we can taken from the battery backup. Just we can taken from the battery backup source. Now, clearly observe here, in this the night time, we can take the power from the grid, that is daytime, from the PV panel, so power is generated, that connected to the grid, and night time, we can't generate the power. With the help of the battery, we can utilize the home appliances. Further, if required for the electricity, we can utilize it from the grid. We can utilize it from the grid. This is the solar power is conversion of energy from sunlight into the electricity. Solar cell, that means which converts light energy into directly electric current. Now, solar energy actually in the space the energy from the sun that reaches the earth is called as solar energy. This from the energy from the sun that reaches the earth surface is called as solar energy. But sun gives 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watts. 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watts. This much of power is available in the space. Much of power is available in the space. Due to the solar radiation, it releases 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watts. But it reaches the earth surface only 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. It reaches to the earth surface only 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. The remaining the power is evaporated in the atmosphere due to the diffuse radiation and then global radiation. It is classified for three types. One is for the direct radiation, diffuse radiation, another one is for the global radiation. Direct radiation means directly from the solar radiation received to the earth surface, without change of direction, without interruption. That is direct line. This is called as direct radiation, or simply it is represented for beam. Another one, the diffuse radiation. It means the radiation at the earth surface from all parts of the sky's hemisphere is called as diffuse radiation. It absorbs in the form of carbon dioxide or nitrous oxide or oxygen, so on, etc. It is scattered in the environment. That is represented for diffuse radiation. And global radiation means the combination of both direct as well as for the diffuse radiation is nothing but global radiation. But in the space, the available power is sun releases 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watts, but it reaches into the earth surface only 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. If you utilize properly, that is this 1.7 into 10 to the power of 7 watts, if you utilize properly, no need to depend for other energy sources, that is the conventional energy sources, either thermal power plant or hydro power plant, nuclear power plant. If you properly utilize this, reaches the earth surface 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts, no need to depend for the other any energy sources. This much of enormous the power is available, is 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watts, but utilizes only for 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. This is the 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. We are not utilized fully. We are utilized partially. That is, how much the power we are utilized means 30 to 40%. The maximum 30% we are utilizing is the power. And which country or which state electricity is good? That state or that country is economically well developed. Because at present, the industry sector is increased, means economically we are getting the good income for input for all the things required for the electricity. That is, which state or which country, if electricity is good, that state or that country is economically well developed. We are depending only for the single source, that is either conventional power plant or non-conventional power plant, that is nothing but the renewable energy source. We can't survive the supply. For that purpose, we are depending for the what are the sources available in the nature we can generate the electricity. At present, day by day, the demand is increased. The population is increased. At the same time, the technology is well developed. To utilize all those technology, the primary thing is required electric supply. Due to that, at present, the demand is increased. That is, the power generation is constant. Is less than the power demand. Demand including the line losses. The demand is increased, but the generation is constant. If you go for the power generation, that is the extension of the power plant, or we can go for the additional power plant, that is either power plant or nuclear power plant, or diesel power plant, the major the drawback is in this the power system. The main motto or the main objective is we need to satisfy for the consumer in the two parameter. One is for the quality, another one is for the quantity. we need to satisfy for the consumer the two parameters. One is for quality, another one is for the quantity. Quality means we need to supply it to the consumer 24 hours in a day without interruption, without disturbances, without interruption and without disturbances. At that time, the consumers are satisfied. And the quantity means we need to give the consumer at reasonable price. We need to supply to the consumer at reasonable price. At that time, the consumers are satisfied. At that time, the consumers are satisfied. If you go for the additional plant or new plant, again the cost is increased. That burden presented on the consumer. Due to that, at present, what are the methods or what are the technology we need to satisfy for the consumer? That is, the best technology is available sources in the nature. What are the sources available in the nature? We need to utilize all the sources. We can generate the electricity. Due to that, in renewable energy sources, it is not polluted to the environment. And the fuel is available for free of cost in the nature. Free of cost in the nature. But a number of advantages are there. The major drawback is it is not continuous and constant power generation and generate the less amount of power. These are the major drawback in the renewable energy sources. That is either solar, wind, biomass, geothermal, OTEC, tidal, and so on, etc. In solar energy, we need to calculate it, how much is the demand in the particular area, how we can fix the PV panel. Actually, the PV panels are placed all the places east-west direction. That is, sun rises in the east. At that time, we can observe for the some amount of the radiation, we can generate the power. And sun sets on the west. At the time also, we can generate the electricity. Some amount of less comparing to the sun rises. The solar time, it is product of addition of standard time. Standard, as per the Indian standard time, less or minus 4. 4 is represent for the constant value. That is, standard time longitude of the location. This is the constant formula for any places. That is, solar time is, that is nothing but the local solar time. It is the product addition of or the subtraction of standard time. Actually, in the particular area, in the region, what is the standard time? Plus or minus 4. 4 indicates standard time longitude of location plus equation of time correction. Here it indicates two sign. One is represent for the positive sign. Another one is represent for the negative sign. Positive sign is indicated for the west and the negative sign indicated for the east. But in India, the negative sign is used. They are placed for the east-west direction. Not for the 90 degree. It tilted some angle. That is 25 degree or 30 or 40 or 45. Not in the 90 degree direction. And if only for the fixed position means, we can generate the power on a day, only 2 hours or 2.5 hours. That is, from if we place the PV panel in the east direction, we can generate the power from 8 a.m. to up to the 11 a.m. After that, we can't generate the power. If we place in the west direction, we can generate the power after 11 o'clock. But before 10 o'clock or before 11 o'clock, we can't able to generate. Few of the scientists, few of the engineers, they identified solar tracker. They are placed in the bottom of the PV panel. Based upon the rotation, based on the solar radiation, with the help of the small induction motor, the panel is rotating. Once the panel is rotating, it is a movable part. Due to that, the maintenance requirement is more. At the same time, the cost is also increased. Next, the solar attitude. And at present, they are used for MPPT control. That is the maximum power point tracking control. Present all the places in the solar, they are used for the MPPT control. That is the maximum power point. The next definition is solar attitude. And another one is for the zenith angle. Solar attitude means it is the vertical angle between projection of the sun rays on the horizontal plane and the direction of sun rays passing through the earth. The solar attitude we are measured with the direct radiation or diffuse radiation. That is the vertical angle between the projection of sun rays of horizontal plane and the direction of the sun rays passing through the points. And another one is the zenith angle. The zenith angle in the solar energy system is represented for theta z. Theta z. The angle is represented for the theta. The zenith is represented for the z. That is, zenith angle is a complementary angle of the sun attitude angle. And the vertical angle between sun rays and a line perpendicular to the horizontal plane through the point. That means the angle between beam from the sun and the vertical. Beam from the sun and the vertical. The zenith angle is represented, that is theta z equal to pi by 2 minus alpha. Pi by 2 minus alpha. Actually, the PV panel are not placed in the 90 degree direction. That is 90 minus a tilted at an angle. That is either 5 degree or 7 degree or 9 degree or 12 degree. They are not placed in the 90 degree deflection. That is, with the help of the zenith angle, we are fixing for the PV panel. We are fixing for the PV. And the PV panels are placed in the east-west direction. East-west direction, because the next topic is role and potential of the renewable energy sources. At present, the renewable energy sources plays a vital role. Two things. One is for the solar, another one is for the wind power. Role and potential of the renewable energy sources. There are two things. One is nothing but the solar, another one is for the wind. Role of solar energy, or it is represented for the importance of the solar energy. Actually, the role of the solar energy is it is renewable energy sources and available freely in the nature. That is, the huge quantity of the energy is available. That is, 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts, it reaches to the earth surface. Just we are placing for the PV panel, can observe the solar radiation that converted in the form of direct electricity, that is DC, stored in the battery. Further, we can convert it to AC with the help of inverter, or else directly we can utilize for the DC energy, the output of the way we are using the battery means it is the fluctuating in nature. That is, solar energy is not continuous and constant power generation. For example, you can take the morning 8 o'clock the power generation is started, the generating the power in terms of either 200 watt, 300 watt. The slightly again increased 10 to 10:30. 600 or 700 watts. And afternoon, 12 to 2 o'clock, again the power generation is varying. Again, 2 to 4, it is decreased. You can compare in a short interval of time, it is not continuous and constant power generation and generate the less amount of power. Due to the fluctuation, we are placed for the battery. The backup, the generated the power, we can store it in the battery. After that, we can utilize it through battery. Comparing to the other fossil fuels, that is, for example, the nuclear power plant or thermal power plant, it polluted to the environment due to carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, sulfuric acid. But the solar and then wind power plant, that is the renewable energy sources, it is not polluted to the environment. And the many applications we can use for the solar energy, solar water heating, heating and the cooling for residential building, solar cooking can used for the cooking purpose, and solar engines, that is the IC engines, it is two method. One is for petrol engine, another one is for the diesel engine, is used for water pumping. At present, this the solar energy is used for the electric vehicles power generation and by solar pumps. At present, we are placed for the PV panel with the help of the battery. We can run the borewell motor also, but the design is different. That complete the setup we need to purchase and we can utilize it. Due to that, we can save for the energy for future, and we can save the environment without affecting of the carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, sulfuric oxide and radioactive substances. And comparing to the wind energy, can be produced based upon the wind, that the effect is presented due to the solar radiation, that is due to the sun effects. And environment and research of the solar energy has brought out of many ways to store them in the form of energy. That actually the solar energy is converted in the form of n number of ways. We can generate the power with the help of directly we can convert the solar radiation into the electricity, or the solar radiation we can convert it in the stored top of the water tank. We can place the PV panel. Due to that, the radiation, the water is heated. Due to the radiation, the water is heated. We can generate the power. And comparing to the other sources, that is solar power radiation, it is eco-balanced system. Containment, the eco-balanced system. It is not polluted to the environment. But out of the all renewable energy sources, the solar and wind is most familiar. Out of all those things, solar and wind is most familiar. In comparing to the conventional power plant, in conventional power plant, we need to purchase the fuel. Fuel cost is more, but the initial cost is less. That is, in conventional power plant, the running cost is more, initial cost is less. But in the renewable energy sources, running cost is, it is available in free of nature. Running cost, there is, running cost is very, very less. We need not to send the amount. But the initial cost is more. Initial cost is more. And what are the potentials? Up to now we have seen for the role of solar energy. Potential of solar energy is, the total potential of the solar energy available is 10 × 10⁻¹⁰ megawatt. You can generate this much of power. 10 × 10⁻¹⁰ megawatt, which is 1,000 times more than the world demand. Throughout the world, we can satisfy it if we utilize the properly in the solar energy. Throughout the world, we can survive with the help of the solar power generation. But no need to depend for the other conventional power generation, that is thermal or nuclear, gas, and then diesel power plants. Diesel power plants. And the solar energy is one of the most promising and the fastest growing renewable energy sources worldwide. Comparing to the remaining renewable energy sources, solar energy is the fast growing. At present, solar radiation is maximum. Solar radiation is, and about the role and the potential of the wind energy. Now we have discussed for the solar. Next, role and potential of the wind energy. And the role of wind energy, or else the importance or the characteristics of the wind energy. Importance or characteristics of the wind energy. And wind is available abundance everywhere in the world. We can generate the huge amount of. And it is classified for two types. One is for horizontal axis windmill. Another one is for the vertical axis windmill. The vertical axis windmill is used for low power generation. That is vertical axis windmill or wind turbine. And horizontal axis windmill. Maximum 95% they will be preferred for the horizontal axis windmill. Generate the more amount of power. It is the permanent and inexhaustible source of fuel. Inexhaustible source of fuel. It is not burning in nature, and it is available in the nature, the free of cost, and it does not pollute to the environment like carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, sulfuric oxide, and radioactive substances. It is not polluted to the environment. Only one thing in the wind energy, visual effect is there and noise effect. For that purpose, it is constructed away from the populated area. That the blade is like a helicopter blade, as much of the sharpness. Due to that, the visual impact is available, and another one, noise pollution is there. Noise pollution is there. Generally, it is constructed away from the populated area. Away from the populated area. Maximum, the wind power generation we can generate at middle of the sea or the seashore area. At the particular places, the wind velocity is more. Wind velocity, before constructing the wind power plant, you need to measure for the wind velocity, that is velocity in the sense speed, wind speed. Based upon the wind velocity only, we can place for wind. And it is clean in nature, and mostly it is available in the offshore or remote areas. That is nothing but middle of the sea or seashore areas. Direction of wind change and never remain constant or regular. For that purpose, we are placed for the yaw control, yaw mechanism. We can measure the wind speed with the help of anemometer. Based upon the wind direction, the yaw mechanism is operated, and we can generate the power. Here also, we can generate the maximum in a day 8 hours. The maximum is 8 to 10 or 12 hours per day. That is maximum power generation. The wind is also not continuous and constant power generation and generate less amount of power. And the potential of the wind energy. Potential means the wind energy is used for, that is, the scaling ships, wind pumps to provide water for agriculture and domestical use, as well as we can generate the power. These are the various potential of the wind energy. And the wind energy, it is used for medium as well as for the large power appliances. Medium as well as for the large power appliances. Solar also we can utilize for low and medium power applications. But the wind is used for medium as well as for the large power applications. Classifications of solar cell. Generally, the solar cell are classified for three types. That is monocrystalline, polycrystalline, another one is for the amorphous. The energy we are from the sun reaches into the earth surface, that is represented for the solar energy. But in the space, the available the energy is 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watts. 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watts. But it reaches into the earth surface only 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts. But if you utilize the properly this 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watts, no need to depend for the other energy sources. Other energy sources. That is, other energy source means conventional power plant or non-conventional power plant. In conventional power plant, like thermal power plant, nuclear power plant, gas and diesel power plant. In this, the power plant, it polluted to the environment. Power plant is polluted to the environment in the form of carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, sulfuric oxide, and so on, etc. And the monocrystalline, the efficiency is very, very more, and the cost is also high. Monocrystalline, the efficiency is very, very more, and the cost is also high. It is used in the foreign, we are not preferred for the monocrystalline, because we are concentrating the main objective of the power system. We need to satisfy for the consumer the two parameters. One is for the quality and then quantity. For that purpose, we are concentrated for the cost-based. The monocrystalline in India are not used because in India, solar radiation is maximum. We are using for the polycrystalline. We are using for the polycrystalline. That is, the efficiency is low compared to the monocrystalline and the cost is less. Why in India we are using polycrystalline means? In India, the solar power generation used maximum polycrystalline method because the solar radiation is maximum per day. 6 to 8 hours is there. 6 to 8 hours. This is used for the peak power generation. This is used for the peak power generation. For that purpose, no need for the monocrystalline. Once the cost is minimized, means burden is not presented to the consumer. Consumer is also satisfied. Another one, the amorphous. The amorphous is also one of the small solar PV panel. It is very least efficiency. It is used for size, calculator, watches, etc. Amorphous is used for solar watches, size, and calculator, so on, etc. We are using the scientific calculator, the top left corner available, the small, the PV panel. The material they used is amorphous silicon. Daytime it is charging, and the night time used in the form of backup. Used in the form of. And advantages and disadvantages of the solar energy. What are the advantages in the solar energy? A huge amount of energy is available in the nature. That is, how advantages means? It is available freely. It is a huge amount of energy available freely in the nature. How much energy is available? 3.7 into 10 to the power of 26 watt, but it reaches into the earth surface 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watt. This 1.7 into 10 to the power of 17 watt is much of the huge quantity of energy is available. And solar energy is free from pollution. It is not polluted to the environment. Solar energy is free from pollution. And creates more number of jobs for employing solar panel manufacturing, solar installers, etc. Once we are kept for the PV power generation, on average, the per site, the required 12 members. 12 members. That is, additionally, the job sources is also available once it is implemented. And solar energy used for thermal applications as well as electrical and chemical applications. Solar energy is used for all the application, that is thermal application, chemical application, as well as for the heat application. And disadvantages of solar energy, what are the drawback means? We are using the battery to store the electric power. It is also can store in the terms of 12 volt or 24 volt battery available in the market. You can place it the series parallel combination. That is, use battery to store extra power used at night time. And the initial cost is also high. And availability of solar energy depends on weather conditions. We can't generate the power light. That is, the timing used is night time during cloudy days and rainy days. And large area required. That is, large area required means open space area. The large quantity of the area is required. It's difficult. That is a major drawback to place the power generation. Today class we have discussed about introduction of the solar power plant and classification of the solar cell. That is, hamare paas polycrystalline, another one is for the monocrystalline. And the solar energy discussed, and advantages and disadvantages of the solar energy. Up to now, any doubts?